Welcome to Let's Talk About It Sunday, an extension of KELA's weekday local talk show, featuring a variety of subjects of local interest. This program was pre-recorded, so we're unable to take live calls on today's show. And now, let's talk about it.
Welcome to the Let's Talk About It show. I'm your host, Peter Abbarno, with another edition on KELA AM 1470 and KELAAM.com. My special guest this morning is the brand newly crowned Miss Lewis County 2023, Myah O'Neill. Myah, thank you for joining me today.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me.
I am super excited because I believe this would be 7 years in a row I had the distinct honor of being able to be the first interviewer of a Miss Lewis County.
Wow. Awesome.
Yeah, you don't seem that excited.
No, I'm so excited to be here.
Are you? So tell me a little bit about this. So you're only been crowned for a week.
Yes.
And so you said to me, I said, is there anything you don't want me to ask? And you said, don't ask me what I've done as Miss Lewis County because it's only been a week.
But, oh, no, Peter.
But I will have to ask you. So how does it feel to be Miss Lewis County?
I can't answer that question. It feels really good. It's super exciting, and it's kind of started to sink in this week, and I'm just so excited.
Are you getting a lot of people reaching out to you saying, we always knew you were going to be a Miss Lewis County?
Sort of. I have a lot of support in this community, and especially the Dance Center, Southwest Washington Dance Center, they were my sponsor, and just coming back this week and just feeling the love and support, and yeah, I just love them so much.
They are an, I don't want to say puppy mill, but they're an MLC mill because they turn out a lot of Miss Lewis County candidates.
Yeah.
I mean, so tell me a little bit more, because I'm so happy that they sponsored you. They're a great sponsor of the program. But what is it about? Is it because it's dance, or is it a mentorship? Why does the Dance Center have so many great candidates put forward?
I think it's a little bit of both. I think dance, the performances we do, is a big factor in preparing for something like the Miss Lewis County program and just getting that performing experience. I know that's something that helped me running for Miss Lewis County. I felt comfortable on the stage because I've already had some experiences like that, and the mentorship too with great teachers.
Yeah. So partly then you've got, half of it is you've got your performance down.
Yeah.
Right? You have your talent, you know what it's going to be, mm-hmm. and your talent is going to be probably dancing if you go to the Dance Center. And then the other half of it is the mentorship and the folks that there that really help guide you through that process.
Yeah.
That's really cool. If you're just tuning in to Let's Talk About It, AM 1470 or KELAAM.com, I'm your host, Peter Abbarno. My special guest, Myah O'Neill, the brand newly minted 2023 Miss Lewis County. So tell me about your family. They have to be super excited about this.
Yeah. My parents are Michael and Amanda O'Neill. My siblings are Evan, Capri, and Lily. They're my three younger siblings, so I'm an oldest child.
How old are they?
Evan is, 16, turning 17 soon. Yeah. Capri's 14, and Lily is 12.
Yeah, a lot of support from them?
Yes, absolutely. They've been so supportive during this journey and just super excited for me, and they're my best friends, so it's awesome.
Well, you crushed it on stage. You did a great job. I was very happy for you.
Thank you.
I was MC, so I got to see all the backstage, the front stage, the everything. What was really interesting and funny was when you were crowned and your parents came to the stage to behind the curtain.
Yeah.
And your mom just looked shell-shocked. I'm like, are you excited? She's like, yes.
Yeah.
I don't know what to expect, but yes.
Yeah. That was kind of her. I was talking to her afterwards and she said, everyone like stood up and started clapping as soon as they said my name after I won Miss Lewis County. And she was just kind of like, wow, what is this year going to be? Like, this is so... I think both of us were shocked. Like, I knew all of the candidates like had a good chance this year, and but I was still so shocked when my name was called. It was like so many emotions, and I think my mom felt that right there with me.
Yeah, no, it was clear, and it's clear from dealing with Miss Lewis Counties of the past and their parents that you kind of prepare yourself for the year,
yeah.
but you can't really prepare yourself because it's so
yes.
unexpected. It's going to be mm-hmm. a new thing every day for you.
Yeah. And talking to the board of the Miss Lewis County program. That's kind of what they've been saying. Everyone's year is different, and that's kind of the beauty of it.
Yeah, and coming out of a pandemic, the last 2 years have been a very different Miss Lewis County in terms of how they interact with the community. Yours is going to be wide open. I mean, there's no restrictions.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Yeah, it is pretty awesome. So talk to us a little bit. We mentioned the dance center. You did a performance. It was called Point.
Yes, it was a contemporary dance on Point to the song Better Days by Dermot Kennedy.
Yeah, and Point, what? Tell me a little bit about Point. Was Point because you were on your point, on your toes? Or
yes, so dancing on Point is when you have the point shoes on. Some people who aren't familiar with dance might call them toe shoes. So it's very different than dancing in just regular ballet flat shoes because you have that aspect of you're on your toes and it's just kind of a completely different world.
Does it hurt?
Yes, it does hurt. But going on point is kind of like a milestone in a dancer's life and kind of something you work up to for so long. And once you get there, it's like a whole new world, I guess, and it's super exciting.
It was a great performance because I've seen a number of different pageants and competitions, not only in Lewis County but in Thurston County as well. And I believe yours was the first I've seen on point.
Really?
Yeah, I don't think I've seen one on point before, and it was really just neat to see how when you're on your toes, how elevated you get.
Yeah,
it's pretty. It's you don't notice it till you're like, wow. She got tall.
Yeah.
I mean, it's pretty cool.
For sure.
Well, so tell me a little bit about some of the other things that you had to do to prepare to be Miss Lewis County, at least for the competition.
Yeah.
So we had the talent, which was dance on point.
Yes.
But there was also a lot of other more academic preparations because there was the Q&A. There was questions that you had to answer.
Yes.
How was that preparation?
That preparation was different than anything I've ever experienced before because I've never had to be in an interview or answer a question on stage. And I think the private interview that we have earlier in the day of competition, that's something that a lot of people don't know about that happens.
Right.
But it was probably the biggest part of my preparation for Miss Lewis County and probably the area that I grew the most into.
Yeah. And so how did you prepare? Did you read newspapers? Did you try to stay up on current events?
Yes.
Just so it was something a lot, because a lot of people don't read the newspaper or if they do, they kind of read the headlines and skim. But you're expected to know issues because you can't fake your way through the Q&A portion.
Absolutely. Yeah. So I listened to some current event podcasts. That was part of staying up to date with what's going on in the world. And also we had mock interviews. Mm-hmm. Several weeks before the pageant day. We had one every Sunday for probably 4 weeks, maybe.
Right.
And that was a huge part of my preparation because it really just got me used to the feeling of being in an interview and getting asked those hard questions, and it really made me think and help prepare for the real interview.
And so you listened to some current event podcasts. You probably followed your state legislator.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you know who that is?
No. Ugh. Well...
It's me.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, well, I mean, that guy too. Yeah, well, I would have asked you that in the Q&A portion of it.
If you were in charge of that?
If I were in charge of it, I would have had you, yeah. Tell me all about the sponsored bills of your state legislator. No, it was, so I did a lot of Q&A prep. In previous years, and Shelley Ford's here with us. She's in the room as well, and she's nodding her head because she knows I was asked. I used to ask all of these really tough questions. And some would be odd, like you'd walk in the room and I'd say, tell me why you chose that color today.
Oh.
Right? And so some people would take offense to it. I was always trying to figure out, you know, is that their favorite color? Does it make them feel good? Does it make them feel confident? It would throw them off thinking I was critical of them. But I used to ask all sorts of fun questions to just kind of throw them off and see how they would react.
Yeah.
Anybody do that?
I had a couple questions like that during mock interviews. I did have one lady ask me what my favorite color was and why. I was actually prepared for that question, though. So,
what's the answer?
My favorite color is pink, and I like pink because I like wearing the color pink, and it makes me feel confident and feminine, and I just feel better when I'm in pink.
Of course, you're wearing black and white today, but go on.
Yeah. I actually didn't get asked very many current events. questions during my real interview, which was something I wasn't expecting, but mm-hmm. they really were just trying to get to know me.
Yeah.
And that was really great because they only have a small amount of time with you. It's a 10-minute interview.
Yep.
And really, that's all they need. They need to get to know you because they want to know, like, if you're going to be Miss Lewis County, like, who is this person?
Yep. Yeah. And we say that, I think, during the actual competition, that this is more than just, you know, what your talent is.
Yeah.
We need to know, are you going to represent the values of your community and represent them well? So
yeah.
part of that is just getting to know the person. And I think we got to know, and I think we chose right. I mean, all of the contestants were fantastic this year.
Yes.
Right? So let's talk evening gown.
Okay.
All right. So you walk out on stage, and there was a gasp.
I actually did not hear the gasp, but I heard a lot about it afterwards.
It was a gasp. It was so. Describe your dress, because I won't do it justice, because I don't wear dresses, so I won't do it justice. But
makes sense.
But it shined. I mean, it glimmered.
Thank you.
It was. It would cheapen to say it was a disco ball, but like you just glimmered. It was super cool. So talk about it.
Well, I actually went and watched a pageant a few weeks before. The Miss Lewis County pageant, and all the girls during evening wear, some of them had sparkly dresses, and I just loved the way the lights shined on the dresses, and I was like, okay, I need a sparkly dress for Miss Lewis County. And I knew I wanted a light colored dress because I have dark hair and I wanted it to contrast with my hair. And I actually bought the dress online and just hoped it would fit when it came. And it did. We had to make a few adjustments to it. We hemmed the bottom, but I was really happy with how it looked. So,
well, describe it. It was
like, white.
It was like, it wasn't just white. It was like snow white. It was like, it was just pure white. And then I'm going to describe it as, I just described it as a disco ball, but it was almost like rhinestones. It was like, there were so many tiny, it was like looking at like stars glimmer. It was super cool.
I mean, the whole thing was covered in sequins, and it kind of gave a, kind of like a silver shimmer on top of the white fabric.
Yeah, it was a beautiful dress. One of the best dresses I've probably ever seen. And justify, I mean, everybody in the crowd went, they gasped.
Wow.
So it was super pretty. It was really
Thank
nice.
Thank you.
So, and I can't remember what your question was. Do you remember what your question on stage was?
I remember to a certain extent. It was something about, I think they said, if Martin Luther King was alive today, what issue would I discuss with him? It was something along the lines of that.
Yes, you're right. And that's a little tough too, right?
Yeah, it kind of threw me off for a second, but I stopped and thought, and I think my first thought after being asked that question was, well, what's important to me? What would I discuss with him? Because if it's up to me to decide what I discuss with him, then one of my passions is education and our youth and children. Right. And so I kind of just went with that along that path. And I feel like he could play a big part in our youth today.
Yeah.
And so that's kind of where I went with it.
And he would probably have some good thoughts on our current education system.
Yes.
Which is a good lead into your social impact statement.
Yeah, absolutely. It worked out really nicely.
Yeah. So tell me about your social impact.
My social impact initiative is promoting self-expression through the arts, and that comes from my passion of dance.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And you see a lot of little kids. The dance center probably has a lot of little kids.
Yes.
My daughter did ballet, little wings and stuff over at Corbett Theater at one point.
Oh.
It's good for them because it's not just about movement, but being on stage, being part of a group really builds good confidence and lets them express themselves, which likely will lead into other forms of expression that we want to encourage.
Yeah, absolutely. And I see that a lot in my students because I'm a teacher at my dance center, and I've been doing that for a couple years now. And just seeing the growth from when they first start dancing to a couple years into dancing, and it's something I really love, and that's what made me want to go into education in the first place, is being a teacher and forming relationships with my students, and that's just like something I can see myself doing for a long time.
Right. I mean, just like you are as Miss Lewis County, when you become an instructor at a dance studio, when you become a teacher, you become so much more than just an instructor or teacher.
Yes.
They'll look up to you. They look up to how you act. You become a mentor and a role model. And we can never, in our community, can never have too many good role models.
Yeah.
And are you looking forward to being that?
Yeah, I am.
A lot of pressure, though, but still, it's good.
Yeah, I'm super excited about it, though, and just excited to get more involved with the community and meet people this year. Yeah. I'm super excited about that.
If you're just tuning into the Let's Talk About It show on AM 1470 or KELAAM.com, my special guest today is a 2023 Miss Lewis County, Myah O'Neill, who was freshly crowned about a week ago. And so just getting her, I'd say just getting your feet wet into the Miss Lewis County world. You're going to be doing a lot of events.
Yes.
Are you prepared for those events?
I think I'm pretty prepared. I think just having an open heart and an open mind and just staying in that excited feeling, I guess, and just, it's really about the people is how I like to think about it. And just, I'm getting to meet all these new people already, and I love it.
You are listening to Let's Talk About It Sunday, an extension of KELA's weekday local talk show. Stay tuned. Let's Talk About It Sunday edition will return in a moment.
Okay, and now back to business.
Listen on the air and online.
KELA.
Let's talk about it. Good morning. You're listening to Let's Talk About It Sunday, an extension of KELA's weekday local talk show. This program was pre-recorded, so no live phone calls on today's show.
Thank you for tuning in to the Let's Talk About It show on AM 1470. My special guest, Miss Lewis County 2023, Myah O'Neill. So what would you say to folks who, and I was a little bit like this early on before I got involved in the Miss Lewis County scholarship program. What do you say to the folks who are like, just a bunch of princesses. You know, we just went through talent. We just went through the Q&A portion of it and your social impact initiative. Mm-hmm. You know, it's so much more than just quote-unquote being a princess.
Yes. You know, that's funny you ask that question because me and Shelley Ford were just talking about that a few minutes ago before this interview. And I think I can give a good opinion on this because I was in that same perspective or those same shoes like not very long ago before I learned about the Miss Lewis County program. And I think really it is more than just being a princess, or it's not just about looks and the crown and the sash and going places and doing fun things, because there are so many life skills that you can learn going through this program. And it's scholarship, and I get a free year of college this year, and it was so fun, like, going through this process, and I've grown so much just in the past couple months preparing for the program, and now I know I'm going to grow so much more this year, and especially preparing for Miss Washington in July.
And I love what you said about that, because I couldn't agree more. The educational aspect of it, but the life skills you mentioned, being able to stand on stage confidently and learn how to answer questions or public speak is a huge skill that most people don't really cultivate very well.
Yeah, and I don't know where I would have gotten this experience if it hadn't been through the Miss Lewis County program.
And you're going to through this process over the next year, and I would imagine Shelley could attest to this as well. I mean, over the next year, you're going to be at so many events speaking that it's going to become such second nature to public speak.
Yeah.
Go through like kind of a Q&A question that you're going to be way prepared.
Yeah. I feel like that's something that has never really been super easy for me. Public speaking, it's always been somewhat of a fear for me. And I think a lot of people have that same fear, but I'm really excited to get more comfortable with it. And already I am so much more comfortable than I used to be.
And if you're just tuning into Let's Talk About It on AM 1470 or KELAAM.com, I'm your host, Peter Abbarno, with Miss Lewis County 2023, Myah O'Neill. So you got to really know the other contestants.
Yeah.
How was that? I mean, did you create that sisterhood that people talk about?
Absolutely. And I think that's something I wasn't expecting going into it from like week one back in January. There were only four of us, which I think made for an even closer bond between all of us, but all of the girls were super great this year and so supportive, and I'm really glad that it was them. Like, I couldn't have asked for a better group of girls to do this with.
Yeah. Who'd you grow to closest with?
I don't think I can pick just one that I got super close with, but there was Callie, Sydney, and Taylor, and I just love getting to be around all three of them.
Yeah. Yeah, and they all did so great. I you know, one of the most unique, I think, performances was Sydney's
her monologue
yeah. on Sweet Tea.
Yeah, I loved her monologue. It was so sweet, and it warmed my heart. Like, I listened to it quite a few times because we all watched each other's talents preparing for that competition week, but it never got old listening to it.
Yeah, it was really a very cool idea.
Yeah.
I'm normally a little bit reticent when someone says, well, I'm going to do a monologue. But hers had, it wasn't just reading something. It was a created monologue mm-hmm. about a history in her family that can be very relatable and tie into love and family yeah. and all that. It was really very well done.
Yeah. I think there was a lot of personality in it too. It was not boring at all.
Yeah. When you were performing, did you hear footsteps like, uh-oh, she might be, I got some real competition here.
No, not at all. I didn't see any of the girls' competition just because of how close we grew during the process.
Well, and I think the Miss Lewis County, just like the Miss America pageant, is you compete against yourself.
Yes.
It's no longer the cutthroat pageants of the past. It's about you honing your skills and being yeah. judged in what you perform or what you do.
Yeah, and that's another thing, because the judges, they aren't scoring you against the other contestants. It's just you and how you did.
Yeah. And so you are attending Centralia College.
Yes.
And you just won a bunch of scholarship money.
Yeah.
So are you using it for school then next year or this
yes.
year?
Yes, I will. Okay. I think I can apply it soon, and I can use it for spring quarter and all of this next year. And I'm so thankful for that. I'm so excited.
And where are you going to school for?
Education. Well, yeah. I'm working on my AA right now. I'll graduate with my AA in September. Mm-hmm. Then I'm going to apply for Centralia College's bachelor program for K-12 education.
Good. Yeah, and you're going to be a teacher?
Yes.
Are you going to be a teacher locally, you hope? Or?
Yeah, I want to stay local. I don't really want to move anywhere far.
Good.
Yeah.
Stay local. Take everything you've learned and bring up the next generation of Miss Lewis Counties.
Yeah.
Did you get to know Brianna, Miss yeah. Lewis County 2022?
Yeah. Brianna, so she went to my dance center too, not mm-hmm. long ago, but she was always levels above me, and she's older than me, so I never got to grow super close with her through the dance center, but getting to be around her preparing for Miss Lewis County, that was super special because I'd known she went to my dance center, but getting to actually like grow close and have something to connect by was super awesome. And she was a really good role model and mentor for me preparing. Yeah.
And I think she's always going to be, she kind of branches off of that tree of Miss Lewis County's, like, at least I see her, and I hope she does and continues, of Kennedy and Bailey and I mean, there's just these folks who stayed. Ann Pedersen, who was an MC with me for yeah. she was Miss Lewis County in 1973. Sean Peters was kind of the stage manager, right?
Yeah.
And Bailey was up producing. There's a lot of Miss Lewis Counties that stay local and stay part of the program on a daily basis.
Yeah.
I mean, Shelley's wonderful daughter took the photos. I mean, it's just amazing to see that they don't just take what they learned and leave. They continue to give back year after year, which is a testament to the program.
Yeah, I was going to say that too. I think it says a lot about the program that so many people want to come back and give back because it did so much for them. And I think that's really special.
Yeah, no doubt. So when you applied for the Miss Lewis County to become a contestant,
yes.
What was that like? I think you went to, was it MissLewisCounty.com?
Yeah.
And then you can download the application.
Yep.
Was it a lot of urging, or you're like, you know what, I'm not sure I want to do this, but I'm going to do it anyway? Or were you excited to apply?
I think I didn't know much about the program, so I was a little iffy at first. I was a little unsure, like, should I do this? Should I not? I didn't know how much of a commitment it would be or what that would look like for me, but I talked to a lot of people who were closely involved with the program or past Miss Lewis counties, and everyone had such great things to say about the program that was confirmation for me that I should definitely do this.
That's awesome. So when did you apply? Was it in the fall?
It was in the beginning of December.
So it was end of fall, early winter, beginning of December. If you're a parent listening or a young woman who's eligible to be a Miss Lewis County, because what's the age? Is it 18?
18 to 26.
Okay. So if you're in that age range, what advice would you give to a potential candidate or parent about the program, why you should apply?
I think the program can be great for anyone because, I mean, everyone has their special character traits or personality traits, and the program doesn't try to change you at all, but it kind of elevates the personality traits that you already have.
Yeah.
And it kind of just brings out the best in you and helps you grow and refine those skills. And I think that's something I really love about it.
So if you're not a dancer, they're not going to try to make you a dancer.
No, absolutely not.
I mean, I'd be proof of that you can't, you know, but you can't make a penguin fly, right? But so what you're saying is what the program does is it helps magnify and hone your skills that are already your skills and make them better.
Yes, absolutely.
I mean, I just think that's great. Great. And I really do hope that, and the program is great and it'll continue to grow. I just hope people continue to apply. It's been so great meeting everyone and seeing the growth from day one to a year after they've become Miss Lewis County, just see how they've grown.
Yeah.
And you're awesome. And you're excited for a fair?
Yeah, I'm super excited for the fair.
That's like that's the big event. That's like a whole week long. You're there every day.
Yeah. I mean, hearing Brianna Rescue talk about it and how much she loved the fair, it makes me even more excited for it.
It is fun, and you will become the most well-known person in Lewis County by the end of summer, if you aren't already, because after the spread in the Chronicle, I mean, you're front page. I mean, it's so cool.
It is. Yeah. It's such an honor too.
Yeah, and then your siblings who are all younger can be like, "That's my sister."
Yeah.
Well, I want to thank you for coming and thank you for sharing everything about the Miss Lewis County program and really looking forward to a year of you being Miss Lewis County 2023.
Yeah, thank you.
Well, thank you for tuning in to the Let's Talk About It show on AM 1470, KELA, and KELAAM.com. I'm your host, Peter Barno. Today, my special guest was Miss Lewis County 2023, Myah O'Neill. If you want to learn more about the Miss Lewis County program, you can go to MissLewisCounty.com. Have a great day.